Alrighty guys, this is the video for goal four for energy transfer. This will be a little bit less intensive than the energy relationships page. So hopefully you'll be able to whip through some of this stuff and learn it pretty quickly here. So one of your first objectives for this goal is to define the following terms and make sure you're uploading these on the energy transfer webpage. Alright, so you're gonna define radiation, conduction, convection, and current. With these terms, there's different meanings for them, although the meanings actually may be the same, there's different contexts. So just make sure that you're using a context of the definition that makes sense in the terms of energy transfer within the biosphere. So just be aware of that as you're trying to define these terms. I would like you to do your best to have these in your own words. All right, so then what you're going to do is you're going to watch the videos below here. They're about 7 minutes total of your time, so it's not too terribly long. And what I want you to do is just summarize the content of the videos on your energy transfer page. So how does conduction, convection, and radiation affect heat and weather? So you should be able to kind of tie the two together and summarize what is in the videos. So you should be able to describe how these work together to create some heat and weather. Alright, you should be able to know what these terms are by the time you define them up in step number one there. Then what I want you to do is do some research and describe what atmospheric pressure is and how it affects wind. So the way you'll do this is you'll go onto YouTube and just find a video that describes the concept of atmospheric pressure and wind generation and upload it to your energy transfer page. So just a quick reminder, you upload a YouTube video by going to your web page. Okay, you're going to go to the toolbar on the side, you're going to scroll down to the media section, you're just going to click and drag YouTube over, and once you do that, you should just be able to click once on the video, and you'll see here that it says YouTube video URL. So what you're going to do is you're going to go to your YouTube page and copy and paste this your YouTube URL link into that section, click outside of the box, and it should upload that video onto your web page. All right, I'm going to delete this. So going back here to our goals, so you should be able to upload this YouTube video. It doesn't need to be long, but it should be able to adequately describe how atmospheric pressure and wind generation tie in together. Alright, so once you have a video uploaded, you should be able to watch it and have an understanding of what that video is describing. Once you've done that, you're going to use the image here below and this Bill Nye video describing wind, and you're going to describe the following definitions. So here you'll see it says Coriolis effect, trade winds, polar easterlies, this should say westerlies, doldrums, and jet streams. I will change this right away here so that says the correct thing there. So what you're going to do is you're going to click on the image. It should pop up with a larger image as you click on it to get a more clear image of what you're trying to describe here. Just look at the direction of the airflow, and here you'll see descending cold air, dry air, and how that affects maybe that region of the Earth. So take a look at this, see if you can dissect what is happening in these wind streams, and then also use Google to help you define and describe these terms here. So that should be good. This image is also found in your textbook on page 374, so you can take a look at it there and see what information the textbook provides you with. All right, you're going to do the same thing for section C. So you're going to use this video and this image to describe how thermal energy is transferred in the hydrosphere. You're going to give just a brief description of the factors that affect ocean currents and energy transfer. So some things that affect ocean currents that I can tell you right now is wind. So you're going to want to look at this wind diagram up here and see how it might affect some of our ocean currents, as well as things like salinity. Okay, so you can check that out, check out some YouTube videos, do some research using the web, and what you're going to do is just give a brief description of the factors. It can even be a list of factors that affect the ocean currents and energy transfer. Okay, type this up and upload it to your energy transfer web page as well. Then for section D, you're just going to look at these images here Okay, this image here of the Earth, as well as this image here talking about biomes, and you're going to just see how energy transfer can affect precipitation and temperature in different regions of the world. I do want you to spend a little time just gaining some understanding as to how temperature and precipitation can affect these areas of the world. So for example, you'll see here desert is in yellow. So you look at areas of the world that have yellow. You'll see in Australia here, there's a large section of yellow. Northern Africa, there's a good section of yellow there. And in parts of southern United States and into some of Mexico, it is considered a desert. So what you want to do is then compare that to this chart, which is also found in your textbook. And a desert will be something that is very hot and very low amount of precipitation. All right, so you should be able to kind of dissect that information, look at what climates there are in different areas of the world. So again, you can say taiga, which is mostly Canada actually, and you'll see that it stretches across like the northern strip of the world, and you can see here that it has sort of a high amount of precipitation or higher amount of precipitation and is actually fairly cold. So you can check that out, compare the two, and you don't need to upload anything for this, but I would like you to just take a look and gain a little understanding of how that works. All right, and to end off this video, I'm going to show you about 30 seconds of these cute, clumsy elephants. So hopefully you're not having as much of a tough time as these little guys are. Good luck with everything, and please don't forget to email me if you have any questions. Good luck!